Hey guys, ChrisFix here, and today I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of a driveway tour. So all the cars I have out here in the driveway, this is about half of the fleet-ish, and here are some of my favorite cars. We'll start off right here with this Maserati. Now, this is the Maserati I gifted my dad because this is his dream car. He's always wanted like an Italian sports car, or in this case, an Italian saloon. And this car is a lot of fun. People make fun of it because, oh, they're unreliable and, you know, they break down all the time or whatever. But when you actually drive one and you feel what it feels like to drive an Italian car, it's something special. So, haven't had any problems with it yet, so can't complain about the reliability. It has a V6 made by Ferrari, twin turbo, and the 0-60 on this, I think it weighs like 4,000 pounds. 0-60 is something like 5.5 seconds, and it is a rocket ship. So a great car for what it is. And let's go check out the interior. I think you guys are gonna like it in here. So you have a couple different modes. You could stiffen up the suspension by pressing that. You could put it into sport mode, which increases the loudness of the car and also increases the boost of the turbos. You have ice mode, which is like an efficiency mode. It makes it more reliable. I should say, not more reliable. It makes it more efficient. Makes it a better fuel economy. Good in the snow, so you don't have as much torque and stuff like that. You have manual mode, so you could shift with the flappy paddle gears. And then we have traction control. So pretty basic. Got the wood knurling in here, which looks really good. And then of course we got that Maserati timepiece in the middle there, which is really cool. And now this car originally came as a white car. You could actually see the white underneath, but we got it wrapped in this really nice blue. And also what's cool about this wrap is it's done in the door jams as well. So you can't tell it's a wrap unless if you pop the hood and look under here. But even so, you can't really tell, which is awesome. It looks really good. So that's the Maserati. There's other features and stuff, but I just want to do a quick overview. Next up, let's go to the Prius. All right, Maserati to Prius. Now, this car I got very cheap, inexpensive. It had a bad hybrid battery, and it was a mess. It looked horrible. Faded paint, no hubcaps. Like, it was a mess. And I fixed it up, made it look really good. Fixed the battery, now it runs like a top. I mean, look how clean this engine bay is. So yeah, that's the Prius. I don't really need to go into it too much. It's kind of, you know, it's a Prius. All right, the next car. This is the car that, this is a cool car. This is our Lemons race car. And I say R because it takes an entire team to do the Lemons race. It's a 24-hour race and it is intense. We change out drivers every 2 hours. And there's a whole process to it. If you guys have never seen the Lemons videos, it's a blast. And of course, Peak is a big sponsor for the Lemons series. So we can't really do too much to the performance because we have to have a $500 car, right? So what we did was we have headers, we have an intake, and we have a junkyard engine because our original engine blew up. That's really all we have for performance. We can't really do much because then the car goes above $500. Suspension stock. Everything else is basically stock. So we have two fire suppression systems to keep the team safe. I'm adamant about having the safest stuff, keeping my team the safest as possible. So we have two fire suppression systems. One goes off automatically. So right here, the requirement is you have a 5-gallon system. That's the minimum requirement to pass tech. We have a 10-gallon and we have another 10-gallon. This is the manual, that is the automatic. So the automatic, you can see there's right there at the end of the finger there is the bulb. If there's a fire, like underneath there where the gas tank is, or if there's a fire in the cabin, where's the other one? The other one is right here. It will go off automatically. That's a gas system so that if the driver's unconscious, they will survive because the flames will hopefully be put out by that system. If you're not unconscious and there's a fire, you pull that, and we have a fire suppression system not only inside the car, but also inside the engine bay. So you can see these little nozzles here. Those nozzles point to all the spots that are most likely gonna have a fire, where there's oil systems. So there's a bunch of oil there, so we have a nozzle right under here. You know, the headers are over here, that's where all the heat is. We have nozzles there. And then we have more nozzles inside the car. So, fire suppression system, although it's kind of boring, is a very important part to this car. Got the Koenig wheels, and then we have nice sticky tires. So, that's the Lemons BMW. All right, now, not competition, more fun, drift car. So this car I got for like $1,000. And as you can see, Car is very well taken care of. Got some sticky tires in the front, drift tires in the back, and then the interior is basically stock with some racing seats and an e-brake. So I redid the steering wheel. You could actually see it actually got torn when I took it for an alignment. The tech who got in had a knife on his belt and it cut it, but that's not a big deal. Plus we have a carbon fiber steering wheel that could go in. I'll do a video on that. Got our fire extinguisher right between our legs so that if there's a fire, we could easily grab that without having to unbelt ourselves. The racing seats, these racing seats are great. They keep you in place, and I got one for the passenger as well because I like to take people for rides. And then we have our hydro e-brake. So this is a nice e-brake and it works very well and it looks super factory because it's in the cup holder and like, just look at that. I love it. I love doing stuff like that. And then finally we have our ChrisFix’s shift knob. So yeah, not really too much to this. It's again, very, very stock minus the exhaust and intake. And that's what it's all about, because you could run this thing all day long reliably, have no problems. Enjoy your event. You're not breaking down constantly and having to fix it. It's just, it goes and goes and goes. So that's that car, and then we have right next to it, the famous Del Sol. So for you guys who might not know, this car was originally just a joke for our April Fool's video, how to change your piston return springs. But everybody on the channel fell in love with it, and I decided to keep it. So you guys know it's getting a turbo. Basically rebuilt the front suspension on this. Stock engine right now, it's gonna get turboed. It has over 200,000 miles, and we're gonna turbo it and see what happens. Got a brand new suspension, new wheels and tires, new brakes, and like, I'm just gonna show you now, like this car needs a lot of work. It is a cool car. The rear window goes down, which is really nice. The top comes off, side windows go down. You have almost like a convertible with a little roll cage or a little hoop. And it is a peppy car without the turbo, because it's very light. And finally, my favorite car, the dream car. This is my AM General Hummer H1. It's a 1996, but it's not a normal Hummer. This Hummer has been Duramax swapped, but it is a great car. 500 horsepower, 1,000 foot-pounds of torque. This thing, 0 to 60, I think is 6.5 seconds. 60 to zero braking, so the brakes on this are interesting. Normally the brakes on a regular car, you know, are right behind the wheel, right? Let's see if I can get in here with my camera. The brakes on this are right in there. They're called inboard brakes. You can actually see this, the drilled rotors right there. And that's so that you have less unsprung mass, and also it's protected. You can see the shield underneath it that protects it. And then here are portal axles. It's another reason why you can't have the brakes here. You could, they do make a kit, but it has portal axles, so you can see the axle coming in at the top, and then in the middle where it normally would come in is a central tire inflation system. You press a button, the tires air down. You press a button, the tires air up. So pretty cool. So this is the interior on this car, and it's all leather, it's all very comfortable. It's a little dated, but I mean, it's a Hummer, I don't care. Like it's rugged, it's military, but it's actually comfortable to drive, and suspension's actually decently soft. Right here you have the fuel tank, so if you want to switch between the main fuel tank, let's just say you're out of gas or out of diesel, you go to the auxiliary. You could do that on a fly. Power windows, power locks, just overall really nice truck. And then if we go in the back here, we have a bench seat in the middle. This is stock for Hummer, which is kind of crazy. It's really made for like kids because there's not a lot of headroom. But then you have your rear seats, which there's plenty of room for those passengers. And yeah, that's the Hummer. And this is the daily. This is the dream car. This is what I love driving around. So there you go. That is the fleet, or at least part of the fleet, because I have other cars in storage. I have the Corvette in storage. It's a C4, 1996 Torch Red C4 that's in storage. I have a Thunderbird. That's my mom's car. That's in storage right now. And I have a couple other secret project cars that are in storage that you guys will see soon that I don't want to give away right now. But hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below. And let me know what car is your favorite, because I'm curious. Out of all the cars, if you could have one, you can't sell it, you have to drive it forever, which one would it be?